guy, I should never be looking over the shoulder unless I'm gonna throw him or something. I want my hand to be flat in the middle of the shoulder. This is where I wanna rest my head. Why? It helps me keep my elbow up. When you curl over the shoulder, it keeps your elbow in. Right? Gives this guy more room to work with something. Push it down, push it down, something. When I'm in the middle of the back, my elbow stays a lot higher. I have a lot more space to utilize different things. Okay? It's hard for him to wing down. He wings down, it's more of a fight. Okay? So, I need to have my hand in the middle of the back. For you. Right? Head position. When you start to take an underhook, ideally you want head position on the same side. Right? If I have head position on the same side, I can attack the near leg. If my head's on the opposite side, I can attack the far leg. Okay? So, where you want your head to be, you want your crown to be just a little bit lower than his shoulders. Right? It's hard to get in if my nose is in the crevice. I need my brow in the crevice of his shoulder right here, or right here. Look at my head position. I'm lower than him just a little bit. That's all it takes to get there. I don't want to be like this. If my brow is above his shoulders, it's very hard to get in. You gotta keep the crown lower than the shoulder. Okay? For high crotch sake, we want our head on the opposite side of the body. We want underhook here, head here. Head either on the wrist or on inside control. Alright? Not everyone's gonna grab inside control. You won't grab your elbow all the time to go inside control. So you gotta force him to grab the elbow a little bit by pressuring him. Okay, that's the next point of emphasis on this underhook pressure. Once you have control on both sides of the body, your head's in position, you need to put the right kind of pressure on this guy so he pushes back. Right? All too often, when we have deep underhooks, guys will walk into each other like this, 2 feet. Alright? We can't have 2 feet pressuring into somebody because it splits our power. We need to focus on constant pressure. I like to say it's like a wave, like a tide, right? It's constant. Beats. Keeps going. The way you keep constant pressure on your opponent is staying in the staggered stance and keeping the same distance between your feet as you pressure him. So if I start here and I'm moving into him, I'm not walking into him like this. My pressure is here. Here. Here, he tries to circle out, that's what I want, him to circle out, right? This is what happens if I walk into him. If he circles out, I get caught off balance. My feet start crossing. When I'm in constant pressure here, if he circles out, there's not much he can do. I'm in balance, I'm ready to shoot, I'm triggered, okay? Keep that in mind. That's probably the most important thing as far as pressure goes in this underhook position. Is you've got to keep your feet constant. You can't be going over each other like this. It needs to be here. Just like you're moving in your stance here, that's how we put pressure on a guy. Alright? So when we pressure and he starts circling out, that's when we can shoot. It's hard to shoot if you just grabbing on you and you're just walking them backwards. I wouldn't recommend shooting just like this. Right? We need him to circle a little bit. So once he starts circling, that's perfect. Right? Once he starts circling, he's giving us that leg. Perfect. And instead of just creating a window and shooting, I'm pulling from both sides of his body when I shoot this high cross. I'm not just going here and dropping my hand. When I make that window, I'm pulling it over. Okay? I'm not just dropping. Alright, we have too much control just to drop our hand. We can get in deep. Here. The pressure starts circling out. Pull. Here. We want to pull from both sides of our body. And the finish is exactly the same, guys. Look at my position. Head up, back straight, trail leg is up. makes it really easy to pivot up and blow right through the sky.
One more time for the last thing so we can go work on it.
Under up, just start it here.
Whatever side you want.
I like this side.
Head on the opposite side. Look at that position. Control something on the opposite side. Small little tidbit. If you're on the wrist, you have to wait for him to start circling out. And then you can grab up.
But once he starts circling out and you go inside control, his immediate heel grab on your elbow.
You don't want to shoot a high crotch from the wrist.
Right?
Make sure you get up on the arm. Put pressure, 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 pressure. You start circling. You're ready to pull. Get you to the knee.
Head up, back straight.
All the way through. Keeping good pressure in your finishes. Ready? One, two.